We're back and you're watching News Channel 3 live at 9. 10 people a day die from asthma and millions more suffer from the chronic illness. With tomorrow making World Asthma Day, how much do you know about the symptoms and treatments?
From flare-ups to life-threatening severe asthma, it's a daily struggle to do something that many of us probably take for granted, which is to simply breathe in and out. Here to talk about asthma is Dr. Jay Lieberman with the Allergy and Asthma Network. Good to have you back.
Thanks.
I am guessing, and I don't know if this is true, is asthma worse in places where you have a high situation with allergies like we do?
Yeah, it can be definitely higher in places with allergies, and you'll see in places with allergies such as tree pollen allergy here, obviously, you'll see a peak in asthma flares and symptoms in the spring where you may not see that spring peak in other places.
Gotcha. Wow.
So, doctor, what about asthma flare-ups versus life-threatening asthma? What's the difference there for those who don't know?
Yeah, I mean, not much, right? Everybody can get a flare-up, and for some people that's, I had to go to my doctor, I got some steroids for a few days, and I was great.
Okay.
And then others have a more severe form of asthma, maybe more baseline inflammation in their lungs, and they get that insult, such as a virus, and they get their asthma flare, but they're the ones that end up in the hospital, emergency room, intensive care unit.
So you don't have a whole lot of time, it would seem to me, to decide if this is a flare-up or if this is really serious, because breathing's not exactly optional. How do you know?
Absolutely. Well, you don't know, and that's why we are very strong about preaching, you know, taking medicine on a controller, everyday basis.
Whether
prevent
you're having
it.
A problem or not.
Yes, and that's the hardest thing to get patients and get people to understand is you may not have symptoms every day. The ones that have symptoms every day are easy to treat, but it's the patients that don't have symptoms every single day to get them to buy in to say, yes, I need to take this medicine so when I get the flare, it's not as severe.
So, doctor, what about the treatments? Are they out there these days for people of all ages? Do they differ as one gets older? What do we see these days?
So, treatments for everybody, absolutely. So, it starts with just an inhaler as needed that opens up the lungs.
Okay, but you carry it with you all the time.
You carry it with you all the time. Take it maybe before exercise, and that's not a controller therapy. That's an as-needed symptom treatment.
Gotcha.
Then there are the controller therapies. You take them every day. They typically are in the form of an inhaler, but they can be pills and they can be injectable medicines as well. The newer forms are typically injectable.
If I have it in my family and I have children, I know I would be concerned. Particularly about possible flare. Like, what do you do in that situation? If it hasn't presented itself yet, but the child is a little allergic and it's very prevalent in my family, what do we do?
Yeah, so see your doctor, see your pediatrician for the kids or your internist for an adult, or see an asthma specialist. So both allergists and lung doctors or pulmonologists take care of asthma. They can do, once you reach about 7 years of age, you can do breathing tests to help out, kind of identify, do we think there's any damage in the lungs?
Okay, because the child might not know to tell you, right?
Absolutely. And then for the younger kids, especially, and for adults, it's really important just to go through symptoms. Are you coughing that's waking you up out of sleep?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a little kid that's stopping exercise before all the other kids because you're coughing or wheezing?
Gotcha.
These can be signs that maybe this is asthma, and we'll treat that and see if it improves.
What about if my allergy problems are only seasonal? Is the urgency, should it still be there? Is it there?
If you don't have, you know, wheezing, coughing, et cetera, then, you know, I don't get too excited about that. However, many of our patients that just have seasonal allergies will have wheezing, coughing, et cetera, during their allergy season. And if that's happening, I think it is worth getting checked out.
Mm. Is it something that you could grow out of?
Definitely. You can grow out of asthma. No one really knows what that is, but kids who have early, you know, viral illnesses and wheeze with it typically will outgrow those symptoms. The majority of wheezers very young in age will outgrow it.
Okay.
Those who are allergic or have a parent with asthma may be less likely to outgrow it.
What about regarding where we live, like Memphis, Tennessee versus maybe Knoxville or areas like that, which might be a little geographically different? Does that make a difference sometimes?
It does, and there's a lot of one issue with asthma, especially in the younger population, is in urban environments. Harder to treat that because of either living conditions, schools, trouble getting to a doctor's office, depending on where you live. So definitely in the urban areas, we do see a problem with younger kids.
Older homes and mold and that sort of effect. We're doing
Absolutely.
More on that this Wednesday, so check that segment out on Monday night. Thank you
so
much.
Glad to have you back.
Thank you.
Good to
Appreciate
see you as always.
It.
Thank you.